Hey team, welcome to another 0 to 1 billion channel episode. This is the channel where we talk all about why you don't need to be a CEO in order to have some impact on the world. This week, I'm going to go all over why it's so important to have the fundamentals down before moving on to more complicated things, and why I decided to stop reading my statistical learning book in order to go back to the fundamentals of linear algebra for machine learning. So if any of that sounds interesting, please stay tuned and watch the video. All right, so welcome to this video. And as always in all my videos, I give you a little snippet of what's to come, and then I go more in depth to exactly what I learned and exactly how I went about it. So the summary for this video is that I learned chapter 5 in the Intro to Statistical Learning book, and then I went on and stopped reading that book in order to go back to the fundamentals of linear algebra and learn NumPy the best I possibly can. So I started a new book called Linear Algebra for ML, written by this blogger who is amazing. I'll link below. And then I basically just thought deeply about why it's so important to go back to the fundamentals when learning machine learning. All right, now let's go more in depth and talk all about what I learned in chapter 5 and in the Linear Algebra for Machine Learning book. So chapter 5 was all about resampling methods. As it turns out, a very interesting topic, in fact, and I had a great time learning, and I found it very easy as well. Resampling is something you want to do when you have a really small test set, or you just don't want to use your test set before you learn about your training set and you got your models correct. Now, let me go more in depth, because explaining is always easier with an example. I'm going to talk first about cross-validation. We learned about two different resampling methods, cross-validation and the bootstrap. Now, the bootstrap is just so interesting and so fun, and I found it just so fun to learn about, and I find the name hilarious and the whole method just to be so, so smart. In fact, one of the authors of this book worked closely with the creator of the bootstrap in the 70s, and so they actually have a book together just on the bootstrap, which is really cool. But the bootstrap is for later, because it is only for when you don't want to use cross-validation. Cross-validation is so good because it works most of the time, and it's so simple. And because of it's so simple and works all the time, we want to use it all the time, and that's perfectly fine. In fact, it will work for most cases. So a very good example of cross-validation is actually k-fold cross-validation, and k can be any number. Usually it's 5 or 10. And you basically split up your data set in order to have a validation set. So we already talked a little bit about having a training set and a test set. Well, a validation set is actually a test set for your training set, if you want to think of it that way. You divide your data set in, let's say, 5 different folds. Then this will be a 5-fold cross-validation. So k is 5. We divide our data set, our training data set, in 5. And that validation set, we actually use it to see if we overfit or underfit our model. We use it to see our test error. So we do that, right? But without using the test data set. So actually, it would be much smarter just to call it our validation set error. We are able to find our error of our model before we even touch our test data set. So this is just awesome. It's just a simple method, and you can find out your error and fix your model before you even test it out with your test data set. So you can save that for later, which is great. Now, let's talk a little bit about how exactly this process is done. Well, it's fairly simple. Like I said, you divide it into k parts. So in this case, it's 5. You use 4 of those to build a model. and you leave the validation set out. And then you train your model, and then you get the error using the validation set to find your validation set error. And that kind of gives you a little bit of knowledge of how your model's doing. Is it overfitting, underfitting? What's the error? What's it bias? What's the variance? Now, after that, in fact, you can actually do this a couple of times, each time with a different fold being the validation set. So you combine, let's say, the first kind of block is your validation set, and then the other three blocks, or the other four blocks, sorry, will be your training set. You build a model, you test the validation set error, and then you actually save that information and then move the validation set from the first block to the second block, and then join the other four together, different set of four now. And you repeat the process to find the validation set error for each fold, and then you find the average of that. And that's how you kind of, you basically make the process I explained the first time, with getting one validation set and the other group. You just do that a bunch of times, so it ends up being even better. So you get such a good result. It's so easy and so good. It's just an amazing process to do, and it's pretty fun. Now, moving on, sometimes you're gonna have a difficult time with that, and you're gonna have a difficult time finding kind of data for your population, and you can't really get a good kind of feel for your data, or your model, really. So what you can do actually is use the bootstrap. The bootstrap's a little bit more complicated. It, you know, requires a little bit more math and more thinking. Specifically, you have to think a lot more about, are you sure you want to use the bootstrap? Because honestly, cross-validation could do everything you need usually, and it's really simple. Bootstrap is a little bit more complicated. So let's move on to the next chapter I read, which is a chapter of the Linear Algebra for Machine Learning book. Now, as I mentioned earlier, this book is made by a blogger, not a professor. So it's actually kind of more like a pamphlet, a short little book that they made that is all about linear algebra for machine learning. Now that's important because it doesn't teach you all of linear algebra. It only teaches you the linear algebra you need for machine learning. And as I mentioned earlier, that this video is all about going back to your basics and how going back to your fundamentals is so important for learning data science in 6 months. As I mentioned in my past videos, I've been learning Khan Academy math from the very beginning. So I've been learning math from counting, number line, to the area of a square, all the way to high school level mathematics. Therefore, I can now pick up any book of a complicated topic, such as calculus, multivariate calculus, or linear algebra, and not be scared at all about what the book is going to have, because I've already set myself up for success from the very beginning. Because of this, I can now, you know, stop my statistical learning book and move on for a short period of time to this linear algebra book and not be scared that it's going to take me too much time or it's going to be too much complicated, because I have the fundamentals and I'm ready to learn linear algebra from the beginning. Now, linear algebra is kind of a wide field, and you know, you have the physicists that learn certain linear algebra, you have the mathematicians that learn linear algebra one way, and then you have the computer science kids that learn linear algebra another way. Really, for knowing machine learning, you only really need to know it in the kind of computer science way and kind of like related to databases, because that's really what we're using it the most. We're using matrices for databases all the time, and sometimes for models for sure, but really, you know, you want to know how to manipulate the data set, and that's why matrices in NumPy is very important. So this book talks all about NumPy, and it kind of starts off the first kind of section. Now this book is in sections or parts, and then it's in chapters, and I find the book so short that I find the chapters are more like sections of a normal book, and the parts of the book are actually more like chapters. So when I say that I did the first chapter, basically I think I did a whole section, really. I'll link below exactly what I did, but this is a free kind of ebook that this guy made, and it's great because, again, I'm not trying to learn all of linear algebra right now. I'm just trying to learn the fundamentals of linear algebra to use with NumPy so I can have my data sets ready for our models. Some models, such as, Scikit-learn or Keras, or even, even TensorFlow, but I don't have much experience with TensorFlow. But all of these models sometimes take your data in a certain way, in a certain matrix. And so if you don't know how to manipulate your data set well enough, you might not be able to plug them into these models even. So this is why this is so important, and this is why I stopped my my statistical learning book to learn this linear algebra, because it's important to go back to the fundamentals when learning data science in only 6 months. That was kind of what I did this week, and that's kind of all I have to share with you this week. Next week I'm gonna continue with the linear algebra book. I'm trying to really speed through it because this book, I wasn't supposed to be reading this book right now. I was supposed to be doing the statistical learning, but I found it so important to have my math background ready so that I can use the Scikit-learn model, so I can use Keras for my machine learning. And so that's kind of my reasoning behind that, and that's why you should always go back to your fundamentals when learning data science in 6 months. And I'll let you guys know for next week what I end up doing, if I'm able to finish the book or if I'm not. So please stay tuned. Subscribe if you like the information, and give me a thumbs up. It really helps. All right, peace.